Hey, it's Steve Overton with Zenco's Consulting. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to build a guided analysis using interactions in SAS Visual Analytics. In this example, I'm going to use alerts generated from SAS's Anti-Money Laundering Solution. At a high level, we'll summarize the entire population of alerts, then begin to peel back the onion one layer at a time. Each section of the report is going to drill down a layer to provide more insight. And this teaches something I like to call an information pathway. It's something I wrote about at SAS Global Forum 2012, and it's a technique I like to use a lot. So here we are on SAS Visual Analytics. I'm going to open up the report, and I'll do a quick demonstration of how it works, and then I'll edit the report and show you how some of the magic works behind the scenes. So at the first layer, I'm showing summary information about every single alert in the system. And as you can see in the top right, I've got a date filter. If I want to filter by year, on the left, I've got a tree map that breaks down the alert category. And again, you can see I can hover over some of these small boxes and see what the particular category is. The size of the box is the volume of alerts, whereas the color, as it gets more red, represents the longer time for the alert lifecycle. As you can see here on the right, I've got two simple bar charts. One breaks down if the alert was a false positive or not, and another that breaks down the alert status. So as you'll see here, if I click a particular category, you can see the bar charts on the right update. So what I want to do is I want to double click into this alert category right here, insurance policy closing, and let's just see, and we'll break it down a little bit further. So as the next section comes up, we're going to be focusing only on what we just double-clicked from the previous screen. As you can see here, it's the insurance policy closing. What I try to do is try to leave breadcrumbs somewhere on the particular screen you're drilling into. So I know that I'm only looking at the alert category of insurance policy closing right here. So in this section, we've got a little bit more detail that tells us who worked those particular alerts. And what I'm going to do here is actually switch this and sort the volume of alerts in descending order. And as you'll notice again here, within this layer of the report, I can click each name and update respective sections of the report. Now, it may be small in some areas, but that's just how the data is. So you can see here in the bottom, we've got a trend. So now we've broken down the particular year we're in by month. We've got another bar chart here to show the status of the alerts that we're clicking here. So out of these eight alerts, we can see the different status of those alerts. We can see a breakdown of the life cycle into different buckets. So once again, if I double-click someone's name, I can drill one step further. And I try to end my information pathway after about three layers, but you can go further depending on the complexity of the data. In my last section, I always try to provide the detail records behind all of the things we just clicked. So in other words, as you progress through each section of the report and the data gets smaller and smaller, you can provide some information until at the very end you can get down to the 11 records or however many records we actually want to see, so we have a small amount or a reasonable amount of data to take action against. So I'm going to edit the report and let's see how this was made. I will say while this is coming up that interactions in SAS Visual Analytics are very, very simple to create. As you can see here, I'm editing the report, and if you just click the Interactions tab here on the right, I can see that for this, for each whatever object I click, I can see the interactions for that. So for this bar chart too, I can see it's filtered by the tree map. Or if I can, click the other bar chart, it's obviously filtered by the tree map as well. Or I can click the tree map and see that it filters both of those bar charts, and it also if you double click, it links to the life cycle section. Another nice thing is the interactions view. So I can see here the tree map breaks down both bar charts, and you can also drill further to the next section. So what I'll do real quick just to show how easy it is I'll click my tree map. I'll just delete these two interactions And as you can see, the bar charts, the values are changing because now they're not linked. But if I add the interactions back real quick, we'll see how simple it is to create interaction. And we'll see here that tree map filters bar chart 2. I'll just start off with bar chart 1. Click OK. And you can see it's starting to change that lower bar chart now. Let's add one more interaction so we can link both bar charts there. Tree map filters bar chart 2. And by the way, you can name these objects in a report so it's a little bit more meaningful. Like, you know, bar instead of bar chart 2, you could say, you know, breakdown by alert disposition or alert status. So as you can see here, in each section, the number of interactions grows substantially because, as you can see here, for the crosstab summary, actually, I take it back. This is the entire section of the report. These are actually all interactions for the section of the report. But if I click a particular object, now it just lists me the interactions for that object. So I can see here that the crosstab filters these other three objects, as well as it links to the detail. And by the way, it's also linked from my summary page. So let's look at the view of this. And we'll see a nice little visualization that our crosstab filters the other three objects in the report. And then the crosstab also drills into the detailed section to provide the low-level record-level detail. And it looks like I also have the line graph doing the same thing. I didn't even realize that. So that's how you make a report interactive from a technical perspective. But it's up to you to design the proper interactions within the data. I typically try to start broad and then drill deeper into the data. So start simple and make it more complex, or start with the least amount of cardinality, then break it down a little bit further. Because as you drill into the data, you minimize how complex things get since you're drilling into a single specific category or type or date range or person. So you really want to understand your data first and the ways your users would drill down, then picture each screen as a level in that hierarchy as you drill. And the goal of the information pathway, again, is to guide business users down a standardized analysis path. So providing summary information at each layer, and then the ability to drill into that layer to see more information. In some cases, this can be pretty effective because you can take an entire population all at once and break it down multiple ways all within a single report. You know, that's assuming the hierarchies naturally present themselves within your data. But again, that's up to you to decide. So as always, remember, everything starts and ends with the data.